The first question is that the stable and unstable manifolds play no role in the shape of a chaotic attractor. This is false. The stable and unstable manifolds are actually exactly what cause the shape of a chaotic attractor. Question two is that stable manifolds have the effect of compressing state space. This is absolutely true. In contrast, the unstable manifolds have the effect of spreading out state space, not compressing it. So question three is false. For question four, in general, an attracting fixed point in an n-dimensional nonlinear dynamical system does live at the intersection of n-stable manifolds. So this question is true. As an example, not as a proof, merely an example, consider the fixed points in the dampened pendulum. The attracting fixed points lie at the intersection of two stable manifolds, and the non-attracting, unstable fixed points lie at the intersection of a stable and an unstable manifold. Again, this is not a proof that this holds in general, merely an example to help you understand the question better. However, this does hold in general. For question 5, we're given the following periodic orbit of a nonlinear dynamical system and asked what we can say about the dimension of the system. We can actually say something. For example, we can say that the state space has to be more than one dimension because it's moving in two directions. But we can also say the state space cannot be in two dimensions because of this intersection. For the deterministic dynamical systems we are studying, an intersection like this cannot occur. If it could, then at this intersection point in phase space, a trajectory would have two directions to go. This would violate determinism. So we know, because this intersection cannot occur, the state space must have at least three dimensions. It could, however, have many more. We can also not say that the periodic orbit is an attractor. It could be that this is an unstable periodic orbit, for example, that does not attract anything. To know if this is an attractor or not, we'd have to find a set of initial conditions that attracted to this periodic orbit. The amount of information that is given is not enough to conclude this. The only thing we can conclude is that the state space has at least three dimensions. Question 6 asks if there's at least one stable manifold associated with every point on an attracting periodic orbit in a nonlinear dynamical system. This is definitely true. One way of seeing this is because it's an attracting periodic orbit, then every point along the periodic orbit, there needs to be a direction of shrinking. Said differently, if at some point along the periodic orbit, all manifolds were unstable, then at this point, the trajectories would be ejected from the periodic orbit, and this would not be an attracting periodic orbit of the dynamical system. For question 7, recall the Lorentz system. This system has three state variables and three parameters, not two, so this question is false. For question 8, the Lorentz system does not model a spring-loaded pendulum. It's a truncated version of the Navier-Stokes equation and models a chunk of fluid heated from below. So this question is false. Question 9 asks, there are two stable fixed points in the dynamics of the Lorentz system for some value of the system parameters. This question is true. For example, consider this picture, which has r less than approximately 25, a equals 16, and b equals 4. Question 10 asks if there's a chaotic attractor in the dynamics of the Lorentz system for some values of system parameters. This is absolutely true, and why the Lorentz system is so famous. For example, see this attractor, which is a chaotic attractor of the Lorentz equations. The parameters used were rho equals 28, sigma equals 10, and beta equals 8/3. Note that sometimes rho, sigma, and beta are called r, a, and b. This can be somewhat confusing, but it's good to start getting in the practice of switching between the names of parameters. Question 11 says that nonlinear dynamical systems can have lots of attractors in different regions of their state space, but only one type at a time. So for example, all the attractors for a particular parameter set were fixed points below, or periodic orbits, or chaotic attractors. This is not the case. This question is false. In fact, nonlinear dynamical systems can have an arbitrary number of all types all over the state space, and there's no way to know a priori how many or what types or what they are. This is one of the things that makes studying nonlinear dynamical systems so interesting and rich. Number 12 states that the basin of attraction of different attractors in a dynamical system can overlap. This is false. If this were the case, then an initial condition lying in the intersection of these basins of attraction could go to two different places. This is not the kind of dynamical system we're studying. Question 3 asks whether Lorentz was the first person to recognize chaos. While some people argue it was actually Poincaré, Lorentz is generally recognized as the first person to recognize chaos in his seminal paper, Deterministic Non-Periodic Flow. So this question is true. Question 14 states that Lorentz was the first person to use the term chaos for this kind of behavior, and this is false. York and Lee were actually the first persons to use chaos, and their paper Period 3 implies chaos.